So today we will revise the chapter The Lost Child. It is our syllabus of revision test second, because in revision test second there will be book movement, chapters of PT1 and PT2 of movement and writing skills. These will be asked in the revision test second. So today we will revise the chapter The Lost Child. Okay. So in this chapter, basically, what does the author want to do? Here, author wants to explore the mind of a child. Okay, what this chapter is about? He wants to explore the mind of a child. See, how does he explore the mind of a child? By telling about his activities. Here, when a boy goes along with his parents to a fair, so he was attracted towards everything. Whatever he sees in the fair, he wants to have this thing, he wants to have that thing. So there were so many attraction points. But at last, when he was lost and his parents were not with him, and when other people came and they wanted to give all those things, that one day he was desiring for all the things, then they offered him all the things. So at that time, that offer was accepted. No, not at all, that offer was not accepted. But in place of that, he wanted only and only his parents. He was expecting that his parents should be with him. So that is how you can say he explores the mind of a child. So the very first point here, writers, he explores the mind of a child. Clear? So you jot down all the points side by side. It also highlights the child's love and affection for his faith. Clear? So, bachche, you write down this thing. Basically, in this chapter, you will come to know that the writer of the chapter, he is basically exploring the mind of a child, okay? And he also highlights child's love and affection for his parents, okay? So what are the main characters in this chapter? Main characters of this chapter is the lost child, what are the traits of that lost child, that he has so many desires, you can say ambitious. He wants to have everything, whatever he sees in a fair, he wants to have all the things. Clear? And next character, that is his parents. Parents of lost child. So what are the personality traits of parents of lost child? Okay. Every time they were telling their child to be with them, But at last, what happened? If the child is lost, it means parents are which kind of parents? irresponsible careless because very small child in fear if it is lost it means parents are careless we can say these parents are careless because fear that is a very risky place anybody can lost so that was a small child so it was a responsibility of a parents to keep the child with them but they were so irresponsible they were so careless because of that carelessness their child got lost in that fear clear now third who is the third part third character the man who found that lost child see one of the child he was lost in the fear okay so when because of the carelessness of that parents that person that boy was lost but the man who found that lost child which kind of person he was tell me which kind of person he was very much helpful and you can say caring how can you say that he was very much helpful and caring because when he found that child okay so he encouraged him and he gave him lots of love affection he was ready to purchase anything for him from that fear to pacify that child okay so it means see that child he was a stranger for him but he was so helpful so caring that he was thinking about that child that child should be united with his parents clear so we can say that person who found that child he was very much helpful and very much caring okay so this is main about this is given in this chapter that three main characters the main character is that lost child after that parents of the lost child and the man who found that lost child okay and in this chapter whenever you will go through this chapter you will come to know that here the person who has written this chapter writer he is just exploring the mind of a child how does he explore the mind of a child because in the beginning when they enter the fear what was going in that so I'm just going to discuss the gist of the chapter with you what was going in their mind because when he enters so he was a child so child was attracting towards everything there were different kind of stalls in the fair so whenever he was looking at all those stalls so he was attracted towards them he wanted to have toys he wanted to have eatables he wanted to have different kind of things okay so let's discuss about all the value points of this chapter you listen also write down the main points also only then you'll be able to revise doesn't mean in literature there is no need to write it requires writing okay so which kind of season was going on spring season which kind of season was going on spring season and a child goes to see fair okay so basically spring season was going on and in that season there was a fair in their village and child goes along with his parents to see the fair okay so when they three were moving in one direction a child was lagging behind child was lagging behind what is the meaning of lagging behind he was not able to keep equal pace with them lagging behind means was not keeping equal pace with them why so You all have got a chance to go to a fair. You all have seen in your life. So there are different, different kinds of stalls. All those stalls are so attractive. But we senior people, we are not so much attracted because we think, okay, it's okay. We see. But child, there are so many attraction points for children. Basically, fair are organized for children so that they can go, they can enjoy. Why parents go there? To make their children enjoy. So he was not able to keep equal pace with them, equal speed with them, and he was lagging behind. Why he was lagging behind? He was not, you can say, walking properly, because whenever he looks at one stall, he was requesting his parent, please stop, and I want to purchase this thing. When they were moving, then he was lagging behind because he was attracted towards next stall. So such kind of things were going in fear. Okay? So which kind of? You should go through, read the chapter and read this also. Okay? So what were the main attraction points for him? Main attraction points for him. For him was choice, sweets, flies, flowers, etc. Rides. So many things were there. Flowers were there, rides were there, flies were there, sweets, toys. So these all are the attractive point for a child. So when he was getting a chance to move there, he was lagging behind. Okay. So when he looks at all the things, so his speed of moving, it became slow because he was looking at all the things so minutely, so carefully. He was attractive. But dare he say to his parents that please purchase this thing for him? Did he dare? No. He did not dare to say that on this point also. He did not dare to say his parents. He did not dare to say his parents to purchase those things. Why? What was the reason behind that? Because he was aware of this thing, refusal will be there. Refusal will be. He was aware of this thing, that if he dares to say this thing, his requests were, it would be accepted. No, his request would not be accepted at all, because he knew this thing, that there will be refusal from his parents. They would not agree to him. They would not accede to his request. They would say, no, this is not good for you. This should not be purchased like this. Okay. So that's why he did not dare to say to his parents that please purchase this thing for me. Up to that chapter is clear? So when he was attracted towards sweets, fries, etc. Okay. After that, he was attracted towards a roundabout. He was attracted towards a roundabout. So when he was attracted towards a roundabout, what happened? See, look at there, that the chapter. There were so many eatables like gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi at the entrance. Okay. After that, a garland of gulbor. flowers, a garland of gulmohar flowers were there. Okay, and there was one person who was standing and who was having balloons like red, green, purple, different kind of balloons were there. Then there was a snake charmer. Okay, he was playing a flute to a snake and he was coiling itself in a basket. After that, there was a roundabout. This roundabout was in full swing. Okay, so many people were enjoying in that and they were shrieking, crying. Okay, there was a dizzy laughter. So after that, when he saw that roundabout, then he made a request, bold request. I want to go on the roundabout, please, father and mother. So when he requested that, he wanted to enjoy that roundabout, that ride, and he dared to say this thing. He put this demand in front of his parents. So what was the response of them? They simply said no. Okay. So when earlier he was attracted towards so many things, he dare not say to them that he wants to have this toys or sweets or flowers. Okay. But when he was attracted towards roundabout, so he told his parents, okay, that I wanted to enjoy this roundabout. Okay, please, father and mother. And when there was no reply, he turned back, he looked at his parents, and they were not either side, not left, not right. Okay, he looked also behind. Okay, so yes. So see, sometimes it happens, every demand cannot be fulfilled. Whenever you was a child, sit down. Suppose you go to any shopping mall or any fair, and if you demand this thing, that thing, that thing, your parents will fulfill all your demands. Even wealthy parents, affluent parents, they will also not accept all the demands of their child. They would purchase only this thing that they think, yes, it is reasonable, it is good, okay, and that should be, that can be given happiness to our child, okay. So it happens with every parents. It happens with every parents. It happens. Sometimes we don't think about money. Sometimes we think the relevance of that thing. And sometimes it depends on the mood of our parents also. Sometimes they think, yes, this should be purchased. And sometimes we think, no, it's not good. You should not purchase it. It happens with every parents, with every child. Okay. So when he was asking for his parents, father and mother, and they were found nowhere, so he started crying in fear. Okay, there was a, you can say, he was completely in panic. He ran to the one side, then to the other, then here and there, in every direction. He started searching his parents, but he was wailing. He was wailing means he was crying badly. Wailing means he was crying badly. Why so? Because parents were not with him and he was lost in that crowd. So then one of the stranger came in front of him, okay, from that crowd, okay. So that person, okay, he asked him that, how did you get there? Whose baby are you? So one of the men asked him such kind of question, but the child started weeping more bitterly. Earlier he was crying, but when one of the stranger asked about his identity, that who are you, who are your parents, like this. So when such kind of questions were asked, so he started wailing more badly. Okay. So only answer he was giving that, I want my mother, I want my father. Okay. So his he was not attractive towards any of the thing, any of the stall, any of the food, any of the toy, any of the thing. His answer was only that, I want my father, I want my mother. So only such thing. So the man tried to console him, he tried to soothe him, okay, and he took him to the roundabout. He thought that when that child would enjoy that ride, I think for some time he would stop crying and he would forget about his parents. Why so? Because his attention would be diverted. Okay. So this concept was tried by one of the person, okay, but the child, it's a fraud, it's that fraud, this neck, okay, it was only shrilling, it was only making sounds, sobbing badly, and he was saying, yes, only I want my father and I want my mother, okay. Then he moved in for next direction, where the same snake charmer, he was playing on his flute, okay, to on swing cobra, okay. So that stranger, he told him, yeah, see, listen to that beautiful sound. But now the child was interested to listen to that sound. Earlier he was so attractive, but now he was not attractive at all. He was saying, yes, only I wanted my
parents,
my father, my mother. Okay. After that, that man asked me, would you like to have that rainbow, different color? Would you like to have that balloon having different kind of colors? Okay. So he said, yes. He asked him, do you think? So he asked him can you smell these beautiful flowers? Can you enjoy that beautiful fragrance? Okay. But he was not attractive towards flowers also. He was looking at them and he was saying, only I want my father and I want my mother. Okay. So there is a humor in that. Last of the chapter is that earlier those were the only attraction points for him. He wanted to have all the things, but he did not dare to say. At last, when he dared to say that, yes, he was attracted towards roundabout, he wanted to enjoy, and when he found that his parents were not with him. Now, all these attractions, all these attractive points, when they were being offered to him, now they were not having any value. See, near about half an hour ago, these were very valuable things for him. He was lagging behind. He was not keeping equal pace with his parents. But at last, when these things were offered to him, people were telling them that, please take roundabout, please take that. Look at the snake charmer, take these flowers, take these balloons. So he did not want anything. He was saying only this thing, I want my father, I want my mother. Okay. Finally, he was brought to the sweet shop, where he was attracted towards different kind of sweets. But here also, he did not want to relish that food. He did not enjoy that food. He was sobbing and sobbing. His throat became dry, and he was requesting only to meet his parents. Clear? Now try to do MCQ. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him, he could not suppress the desire of his heart. Even though he well knew the old, cold stare of refusal in their eyes. Who are he and they in the above extract? The little child and his parents, the little child and his teachers, the father of the child and shopkeeper, the shopkeeper and the child's parents. Online students, type in chat box. Online students, type in chat box. I'm reading your answers. What is the desire of his heart? What is the desire of his heart? To buy a present for his mother, to buy a present for his father, to buy a present for himself, to buy the toy he has seen. Type in chat box, online students. Yes. To buy the toy that he has seen. Which word in the extract means the same as hold back? Which word in this extract mean same as hold back? Steer, suppress, refusal, stop. Hold back. Don't make guesses. Don't make guesses. Tell me answer of this MCQ. What will be the another word for hold back? Chair. What is the meaning of chair? Speak in English. Huh? How many are saying stair option is correct answer? Shame on you. Stair means to look at somebody for a long period of time. Refusal, to refuse. Stop, you know. And suppress. If you put some request in front of me, I'm going to suppress that demand. So it means suppress that I'm saying. I'm holding back because I'm not accepting your demand. I will say I will accede to your demand later on. So what will be its answer? Its answer will be suppress. Clear? Next we have, the child watched them intently. And then he made a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout. Please, father, mother. There was no reply. He turned to look at his parents. Who are them in the above extract? Who are them in the above extract? Shopkeepers, children, the child parents, the men, women, and children riding on a roundabout. Yes. The men, women, and the children riding on a roundabout. Why was there no reply? Because the parents were nearby. Because the parents were not nearby. Because the child spoke in a very low voice. Because the child did not speak anything. Because the parents were... Find a word in the extract which is a synonym of keenly. Synonym of keenly. Tell me its answer. Keenly. Slowly, intently watched. Slowly, intently watched, attentively. Hmm? Tell me. Keenly. How many are saying attentively? Shame on you. How many are saying watched? How many are saying watched? Slowly. Intently. Yes, intently it is your right arm. Okay. Now let's move to next question. Select the opposite of bold. Bell has gone. We will continue this topic tomorrow. But you can tell me, bold and tawny, wait. Bold, opposite. Timid, candid, slow, uneven. Yes, bold. Bold. Timid. Bold means very much strong. Brave. Timid. Who is weak? We will do next chapter tomorrow.